Let's talk about flowchart. So for this series itself, we'll be learning the format of flowchart and how to draw a flowchart based on a given problem statement. First of all, let's look at the format of flowchart. So a program flowchart uses the following symbols. So first of all, we have this here, which is for start and stop. And then we have this rectangle here, which is for assignment or action. And then we have this decision box here, which is for condition here. Let's say the condition is yes or true, it will be this way. Or the condition is no or false, it will be this way. Next will be flow lines to show the sequence, and lastly will be input and output using this shape. Now let's look at how we can draw a flowchart based on a given problem statement. So first of all, this is a problem statement. Write an algorithm to find the average of a number of integers. Both the number of values and each integer are to be input, and the average is to be output. So this is the exact same question as the structure English and the pseudocode example in the previous videos. So let's look at how can we do this using flowchart. So first of all, we'll start with this start symbol here, and next will be total is equal to 0 and counter is equal to 1. So this is an assignment, and next will be output, enter the number of values to average. So this shape here is for either input or output. So just imagine that in the console itself is showing enter the number of values to average in your computer, and next will be input number, means that you are just typing number of values to average into your computer now, and you'll be stored as a number variable. And then output enter value means that the console will just show enter value right now. And then input value means that now you're just typing the numbers into the console. And then we will do more assignment here, which is total is equal to total plus value, counter is equal to counter plus 1. This is so that we are just summing the total from 0 based on the new number that you have typed in. And then we'll just increase the counter by 1. And next will be a condition shape asking for is counter more than number, means that we are asking whether have we input all the numbers to average. If it's a no, it will just go back to here again. Output enter value means that you can just enter the next number. If it's a yes, we'll be just doing more assignment here, which is average is equal to total divided by number. Finally, you output this. Output the average of how many numbers value is the average number. So it means that the final output will be something like this. The average of 5 value is 3. And lastly, we'll just end the program. So this is how we can use different shapes and statements to come up with a final flowchart based on a given problem statement. I hope you learned something new from the video. Definitely give my video a thumbs up, leave your comment, and please subscribe to the channel. Thank you, and I will see you again then. Bye bye.